Morning everyone. I am presenting a phase 2 study of oral metronomic chemotherapy in multiply relapsed epithelial ovarian cancer. So as we know that advanced epithelial ovarian cancer has a very high relapse rates despite the full treatment. And there in the relapse setting, there is lack of any proven superiority of one drug combination or the single drug over the other. And we all know oral etoposide we all have used in ovarian cancer. Etoposide we have used in ovarian cancer. Tamoxifen has also been shown too. So as per yesterday's discussion, similarly we try to combine these two or three drugs in a minimum dose setting where we could get the benefits. So metronomic therapy is a continuous administration of chemotherapeutic agents at relatively low doses. So we are trying this for the ovarian cancer. So we evaluated the oral continuous low dose metronomic combination of these three drugs, etoposide, cyclophosphamide and tamoxifen. So the aims were to evaluate the efficacy and toxicity of this combination in patients of epithelial ovarian cancer who have relapsed or progressed after two prior lines of therapy, and to evaluate the mechanism of action of this regimen by evaluation of angiogenesis and apoptosis in baseline and post treatment biopsy samples. So histological inclusion criteria was histological confirmed epithelial ovarian cancer, achievement of CR after first line of therapy and at least PR as the best response after second line of therapy, disease progression after second line of therapy, baseline CA 125 more than 40 because we want to analyze it by Rustin criteria, performance status 0-2, adequate other organ functions and informed consent. Any patient with subclinical partial or complete intestinal obstruction were not taken in the study. So we selected relapsed ovarian cancer patients, previously CR as I have already described, informed consent, and the doses used were etoposide 50 mg per meter square day 1 to day 21 every 28 days. Similarly, cyclophosphamide 50 mg per meter square day 1 to day 21 every 28 days. The dose of tamoxifen was high, 20 mg per meter square twice daily as a continuous drug. So this cycle was repeated every 28 days. So there was a gap of 7 days for etoposide as well as cyclophosphamide, and tamoxifen was continued. And clinical evaluation was done before every cycle, and radiological evaluation was done after every 2 to 3 cycles. The primary endpoint was the serological progression-free survival as per the Rustin criteria. The secondary endpoints were the overall survival, 50% serological response, duration of serological response, duration of radiological response, radiological progression-free survival and evaluation of toxicity. So baseline characteristics, number of patients were 26, median age was 48. 88% of the patient had received taxane and platinum combination at the first line therapy. Median PFS after first line therapy was 18 months. Platinum based second line therapy, again 88% of the patients have received. CR after second line therapy was in 54% of the patients. PR after second line of therapy was in the rest 46% of the patients. Median PFS after second line of therapy was 9 months, and third line chemotherapy was already given in 20% of the patients. Out of the 26, 5 were platinum sensitive patients. 11 were partially platinum sensitive patients with a PFS of 6 to 12 months for the last therapy, and 10 were platinum resistant patients. Treatment delivery. So median cycles delivered was 7. One patient was lost to follow up after the first cycle only. Only 50% of the patients were able to take 67% of the planned dose for cyclophosphamide and 63% for the etoposide. So the toxicity was very high in this set of patients, and we have to reduce the doses in near about 50% of the patients. So the dose intensity of cyclophosphamide which we achieved was 0.67 only. For etoposide also it was 0.63 only. For tamoxifen it was going up to 0.9. So because of the toxicities, we reduce the doses of cyclophosphamide and etoposide. Total cycles were 203, evaluable were 180, because few patients took two cycle or three cycle therapy at home and then return. There were grade 3 and 4 toxicity in 100 events were there. That was present in, you can say, 32% of cycles. It was present in 80% of our patients. So showing that how toxic it was there. Dose reduction was done in 52% of our patients, and we have to reduce the actually modified in 50% of the cycles. Major toxicities grade 3 and 4 were anemia and neutropenia. We do see nausea, vomitings and mucositis, but it was usually grade 1 and grade 2. The dose modifying events which led to dose modification were mainly neutropenia and anemia. Results: CA125 response as per Ruskin criteria, 12 of our 40, means 50% of our patients achieved complete response. 28% patients received 75% response, and 6% of the patient have stable disease. All patients have progressed at the time of analysis, and median time to 75% serological response was 1.8 months. And median duration of response was near about 7 months. So Kaplan-Meier for the duration of serological response, it was coming around 7 months with a range from 5.8 to 8.2 months. 11 of our patients have a complete or partial radiologically response. And median time to radiological response was 3.6 months, and median duration of radiological response was near about 5.5 months. The serologically PFS, progression-free survival, was 8.63 months. The radiologically progression-free survival, again, it was coming around 8.1 months. The overall survival, 22 patients have already expired out of the 26 patients. The median overall survival was 19 months with a range from 13 to 24 months. We compared our results with the Gordon trial, in which the second or third line therapy has been used, and Lipodox versus Topotecan has been compared. In this study, the platinum sensitive patients have an overall survival of 26 months, and resistant patients have an overall survival of 10 months. In our study, we have combined both the sensitive and resistant patients, and the overall survival was near about 19 months. So we haven't differentiated because of a small number, we haven't differentiated between the platinum sensitive and platinum resistant patients. So the conclusion is that oral combination of etoposide, cyclophosphamide and tamoxifen is effective in patients with epithelial ovarian cancer who have relapsed after at least two lines of therapy. Thus, responses to this regimen are durable with a median PFS of 8 months. This regimen is planned in our study was associated with toxicity requiring dose modification in half of the patients, and this regimen with some dose modification should be studied in large randomized trial. Thank you.